Hello, welcome again. We are solving IDJ physics. The topic is magnetic effect of current and magnetism. Question number 21 from year 2019 is, an electron is moving along plus x direction with a velocity of 6 N/6 m/s. It enters a region of a uniform electric field of 300 volts per centimeter, pointing along plus y direction. The magnitude and direction of the magnetic field set up in the region such that electron keeps moving along x direction will be 1 5 N/-3 Tesla along plus z direction, 2 5 G/-4 Tesla along minus z direction, 3 3 N/-4 Tesla along plus z direction, 4 5 N/-3 Tesla along minus z direction. Okay. Suppose now it is given that the electron is moving in plus x direction. Okay. So electron is moving in plus x direction and the electron carries negative charge. Okay. And electric field is in plus y direction. Okay. So as electrostatic force is Q22 Jee and the electron carries negative charge, so the electric force will be in downward direction. Okay. So now for the electron to keep moving in plus z direction, an upward force which is equal to this QE should act. Okay. When a magnetic field is applied. Okay. And FB is given as QVB. So as FB is your upward and Q is your negative and the charge is your negative. Okay, so we can assume it as FB is upward and the velocity of the particle is in this direction. Okay, and the current carries negative charge. So we can assume that the velocity will be your velocity of electron velocity of current is in this direction. So current is going in this direction. So now the current is going in this direction or QV is in this direction and it is making a we are assuming that the magnetic field acts in this direction. So it is making an anti-clockwise sense with the magnetic field. So when this sense of this QB with the magnetic field is in anticlockwise, so applying your right hand screw rule, so this is anticlockwise and the force looking from above, which is anticlockwise and the force will act in upward direction. So this FB will act in upward direction because electron is carrying negative charge. Okay, so we can assume that the current is moving in this direction. Okay, so so the FB will act in upward direction. So this comes out when the magnetic field is applied in this direction. Okay. So now balancing this electric force and magnetic force, we have E is equal to VB and E is given as E is given as 300 volt per centimeter or 300 into 100, and V is just 600 into 6 and B is 500 into 3 Tesla in positive z direction. Okay. So answer is 1. Next, an electron moving along x axis with an initial energy of 100 electron volt enters a region of magnetic field B is equal to 1.5 × 10⁻³ Tesla K at S. See figure. The field extends between x is equal to 0 and x is equal to 2 cm. The electron is reflected is detected at point Q on screen placed 8 cm away from point S. The distance D between P and Q on the screen is electron charge is equal to 1.6 × 10⁻¹⁹, mass of electron is equal to 9.1 × 10⁻³ kg. Okay, so this is the point where the electron enters the magnetic field and this is the potential energy of the electron is 100 eV, or in joule it is 100 × 1.6 × 10⁻¹⁹ joule. Okay. And mass of the electron is 9.1 × 10⁻³¹. And velocity of the electron is v, so it is half m current. So this energy will be converted into kinetic energy, and kinetic energy is half m v square. So v square is equal to 1.6 × 10⁻¹⁷ or 2 ÷ 9.1 × 10⁻³¹. And v square is equal to 0.3516 × 10⁻¹⁴. Or 35.16 × 12, or V is equal to 5.91 × 10⁻⁶ approximately. Okay, 5.9 we can take. So this is the velocity of the particle. Okay, and the particle when the electron comes in electric field, it traces a circular path. Okay, so this is a portion of the circular path. Okay. And okay, and so V with V being 5.91, and now this particle moves under the influence of centrifugal force and your magnetic force. So from this fact, we can determine the radius of the circular path. So mv square by r is equal to qb, mv divided by qb r, and m is your 9.1 × 10⁻³¹, and V is 5.91 × 6, Q is 1.6 × 10⁻¹⁹, and B is equal to 1.5 × 10⁻³¹, or because all the values are given, the R comes out approximately 22.4 × 10⁻³ or 2.21 cm. So now this is the point of the circular portion, and the velocity of the particle at the entering the magnetic field is in this direction. So the center will be approximately on this line. Okay, so if we take 2.25 cm from this point, then it will be center of the particle, center of rotation of the particle. Okay, so this is 2.25 cm. Now the particle is here, so this will also be the radius. This is also radius. Okay, now this is a radius, and both are radius, so and this angle is cos theta. Now we can determine this angle because this is 2 cm, this is 2.25 cm. Okay, and we can determine this AD also. Okay, from the right angle, angle is 2.25 cm −2 cm². So it will be approximately 1.03. Okay, now at this position the particle has velocity in this direction. And now this is the exit point of the magnetic field, so there will be no influence of magnetic field after this. So the particle will keep moving in this direction with velocity at this point. Okay, the velocity at this point in this direction, same velocity. Okay, so now PQ is given by B. Okay, and this is your, this is given by R cube plus PR. Okay, and this angle is theta, that we can determine from this angle also. Okay, and this is your 6. Okay, and this is your 6, and this angle is theta, so we can determine the distance R cube. So R cube is your 6. So this is your perpendicular, this is your base, so RQ is your 6 into tangent theta, and tangent theta can be determined from this. So this is your perpendicular, okay, and this is your base, so this is 2 by AD, 2 by 1.03. And now PR is AS minus BS. Okay, so it is S